talk about file management and file sizes in particular. We've already talked about file management when it comes to one of the very early videos, file, save as a project versus save as a tool mesh. Generally, especially for my classes, it's usually tool save as is what you're going to want to do. So for example, I've got a boot here. So if I wanted to save this as something that I want to open up later, I'm going to go to have the boot selected, go to tool save as boot. If I have a weapon here, I can go tool save as weapon. The added benefit of this is that if you send me a project and I have a bunch of student tools loaded up, now I have to open your project and it's going to completely obliterate anything over here and then I have to load in the tools later. Another added benefit is that you're not going to get a bunch of garbage in here. If I had a bunch of tools, like say I wanted to save just this weapon and not the boot, if I go to File Save As, it's going to save a Z project and it's going to have both of these tools available to me. If I just want the boot or I just want the weapon, Tool Save As is going to get you there. Now let's talk about file sizes in particular. So let's say I have this weapon selected and I go to Save As, and I'm just going to throw this on my desktop. Let's call this weapon. And if I go to Save As again, you're going to see we have the Weapon Z tool and it's 600 megabytes. For a 1.278 million object, that's really dang high. That's really bizarre. So what I'm going to do, and if you go and watch the Z plug installation, we actually installed this particular plugin. I'm going to go here to Clean Tool Master, and you're going to see down here there's Subtool Cleaning and Decrease Z Tool File Size. So things that can really increase your file size are these things up here, as well as down here like your UVs. If you're not using UVs for any particular purpose, I would say delete your UVs, and you can do delete on UVs all. You can delete all your morphs if you're using them, and you can delete all your layers if you're using them. Usually, there's very specific reasons to use these things, but really the big one is probably UVs. Another thing you may not be aware of is if you do show hidden. So if you show hidden all, a lot of times you'll have geometry that's just sitting hidden inside of a subtool that you're not aware of, and you can go through and you can delete that. So now if I go here to save as again, we'll call this weapon 002. Hit save as, and unfortunately, it didn't do anything. It's the exact same file size. So there is another option. It's kind of a pain, but it does pretty drastic things to your file sizes. Let's go to subtool here. I'm also going to turn on everything so I can see everything I have in my scene. And the reason I'm going to show everything is if I go down here to my merge, I can do a merge visible. That's going to go ahead and merge all of these subtools, all 107 of them, into one subtool over here. Still the same object, still all the same vert information, but if I go to save as, and let's call this weapon 03, and then go to save as again, you're going to see it went from 600 meg down to 29 meg. It's still the exact same information, but boy, it ballooned up. Now, the bad thing about this method, it's great for reducing file sizes, getting rid of any ZBrush gremlins that might be residing. But the bad thing is, if I hold down Control Shift and isolate this, we can go ahead and split this off. So I've got this body, base body is just kind of a placeholder for scale and size information. So if I go ahead and turn his eyeball off and I go back down here to the weapon, all of these things are merged again. Now, it's not a huge deal if before you merged everything, you had everything split into polygroups, because you can go down here to split, group split. You can also go to split the parts, split the similar parts. So just as a quick way to get this thing divided back up, I can go to split the similar parts. And fortunately, that's pretty much what I had previously. Another thing you're going to have to do is if you set up your creasing, the creasing is going to stay. So you can see all of these items are all still creased. However, our dynamic has been turned off. So under all of these, you're going to have to do dynamic. And then say, you know, smooth subdiv of 3. And then crease level of 2, or whatever you want to do, you know, smooth subdiv of 4, crease level of 3. There you go. So for all of your objects, you'll have to go through and do that again. It'll still maintain your creasing, you'll just have to reset this up. If you want, let's try this. So under Z repeat it, we can try recording that action. So we'll hit record new, and with this object selected, we're going to say turn on dynamic, set smooth subdivision to 4, crease level to 3, and then end record, and we'll call this dynamic subdiv base. This will be the baseline for my dynamic subdiv. So now that I've done that, we now have a dynamic subdiv base in here stored. So then we can just do that to all my visible subtools. And now that it's stopped, you can see these have been updated to have that dynamic subdivision. Now in this particular case, that wasn't a great idea because some of these things were dynamesh, so now I have dynamic turned on for very high resolution objects. So what probably would have been a better idea is for me to manually go through here and alt tap these and then hit run Dynamic Subdiv Base for selected, and that'll just get you through that process a little bit faster. If you want to turn dynamic off for everything, let's record new, turn dynamic off, and record. We'll call this dynamic off, and now we'll just run that for all visible. So anyway, now that we've merged everything, we've talked about dynamic subdivisions. Let's go up here to save as. We'll call this weapon 04. If you hit save as again, you're going to see weapon 04 is still, even though we've turned dynamic back on, we're at a much, much lower file size. So to get rid of your gremlins, merging visible is a really quick and easy way to do that. There's a little bit of work after that, but it's kind of worth it to save on your file sizes.